One thing is so amazing, it seems the river is completely detached to all of this noise and pollution and chaos and business and stores and all population coming in. The river just flows. It seems like a lesson to learn where you have to just keep going no matter what others think of you, what others say to you, what happens to you in life with regard to others, circumstances. You just keep going towards your goal, towards what you want to do in life. Just like the river, nothing stops the river from flowing. Hills, dales, valley, mountains, rocks. Just keeps flowing no matter what. Amazing. Look at those hills there. Beauty of those hills. So tall, so majestic. I can't wait to be up there. I'm going to be up there very soon in my trek, searching for those temples of Shiva established by the Pandavas. Well, I sit next to this lovely sage here. Hello, Bhagiratha. I hope I can get him. There he is. And my favorite god of all, Shiva. So easy to go with the flow, right? So difficult to stand up against the flow or go against it. I mean, the question comes to my mind, why go against it? If nature intended, then we just go with the flow. But spirituality is going against nature, against the senses, against the body, against the flesh. It's a new path. It's not, that path is not defined in the dictionaries of the human mind. It has been given to us by consciousness of a higher kind. And therefore, in order to follow that path, you go against the current of the river. That's what makes it difficult. That's what makes it seem you are the only one, and you feel oftentimes alone in this path. But you're never alone. With every step you take against the current, there is an energy that guides us. Lessons come as I stand in front of these Ganges, mighty river. The aloneness, Kaivalya, the gift of yoga.
Shine.